on the hunt to find some greenery. Wait, this is so blurry. Good. Sounds very silly, but it won't be as easy in this forest. I mean, look around. There's no life underneath these already dead trees. And so I'm gonna walk to the end to see if there's more. Okay, I find some branches. So I'm just going to grab these. To you. I mean, just look at that greenery. I mean, look at this. Do you see that all this green? You can tell the rain is back. So here's the situation. In some of the areas where I want to decorate, I'm just going to only decorate the window. It's like the kids' room, because that's going to decorate the house outside and inside, and it doesn't take up much space. So I have these star lights that I have to detangle. Good luck, Noemi. Do you wanna help me?
Okay.
I need help. Should I put up in your window like that?
Would be a lot quicker. Oh. To me, it's
wow. In love. Okay, so these are all the decorations that I have for Christmas, including the ornaments. So I'm going to work with that. So I'm going to use the ivy that I find down in the forest, and I'm just going to kind of twist them together. And I have some bells and red berries that I'm just going to wrap around that, just to hold that together and add some colors. So this year I really want to use some red and golden. This is a very inexpensive way to decorate for Christmas. Also, it brings life to the room because it's a real greenery, and I don't have to store it during the year. I can just grab another one next year. So it definitely simplifies the Christmas decoration storage, and also I can change it around each year to choose something different. I'm definitely going to make more of this garland, and I'm planning to add to the doorways as well, but for now I'm just going to do the fireplace. And I'm sure I'm going to change it around a little bit because it's just fun, and I'm definitely going to have more on decoration. So it's not just one video that I'm going to post, it's just an early one so you guys can get inspired. And I felt like this year I just really want to celebrate Christmas a little bit sooner, just bring in some light into the house and joy. a few weeks ago we redid this part of the living room and we just added some boards to the wall, and this is what I was looking for too, that I can decorate this little shelf around it. So it's gonna be perfect for those little houses and little trees. These are all from Target from last year, from the dollar section, and I'm going to put out this little countdown, and I just realized the date. That's why I made the face. So that's how we kind of counting down until the Christmas. Right now I'm just putting the date there because I don't have the numbers for that, and I'm going a little bit more whimsical in my art studio area or this part of the living room. I just kind of like the woodland theme so much and the mushrooms. I'm going to create a little decoration for my pantry door, and these little greeneries that I have is just such a classic one. It's very easy to add some red color, golden one. I mean, you can change it around. That's why I just love the simple green ones. I can even use them on the summer just to add some flower to it. So now I'm going to add some bells, and that's just going to be a very simple one. They're just going to hang down, and that's what I'm going to use for decoration in the kitchen. Cause all I wanna do is spend this holiday with you. Tomorrow it is Christmas, the first for me and you. I longed for this moment to have you for myself in a cabin out. Sometimes I'm just going back to add some details where I already decorated. That's just how it goes. I'm getting new ideas. So I added this little string light to it as well. I think it just looks even more cozy that way. And also I like to use little leaves and fruits to decorate for Christmas, and this pretty much that you can see on my painting as well, that this is the same thing, mushrooms, little leaves and just things in the basket. In a cabin out in nowhere, just us and no one else. I did scan fair for 6 years and I really missed that, but this year I'm not going to make it there, and last year I didn't make it there either. So it looks like I'm going to just make my things at home. So this is the leftover that I have when I was preparing for that, and I'm going to basically just glue this little mushrooms and little trees and whatever I have leftovers. And probably I'm going to do this with my friends. I'm going to invite them over for a craft night, and it's a very simple, easy decoration. It's great for gift as well, and every time when I was selling them they went very fast. And this is another thing that I made last year, and it's a wreath. And also I'm going to share all those videos down below in the description box where I shared how I did all of these and just getting other ideas. I'm going to leave you a little preview at the end of this video where you can see what else I can offer in those videos, but all will be down below in the description box as well. So as I'm decorating, there's no cooking or baking without making a video and making a mess. So I decided I'm going to make that cookie that I made last year, and I'm just really wanted to just figure out the recipe even further, and I think I nailed that. So now I just have to measure it out. It always goes out when I start to measuring things out, but I will give a try. And this little spoon is actually very nice to fold the dough while it's very sticky. And then I will switch to my hands, and I'm going to put it into the refrigerator to rest it a little bit over there. So after 1 or 2 hours it rested there, I'm just going to cut them out and then bake them. And I'm going to add some raspberry jam in there. Basically it's just a sugar cookie recipe. So if you don't want to use gluten and dairy free, you can use whatever sugar cookie recipe recipe you have, is this a shape that I really like, and the raspberry jam, that's makes a difference. I don't know, something with that jam, it just makes a perfect match with that dough. This is a super easy to make cookie. It's very simple. Basically, it's just filling up with some jam. Final touches with some powdered monk fruit that I previously put some vanilla beans in there. So that was for the today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed that, and here are some ideas from my previously made videos, which will be down below in the description box if you want to see those. There's more decoration videos, and of course we're going to cut the Christmas tree, and then we're going to decorate that and getting ready for the Christmas, so there will be more content on that. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys soon in the next one. Bye!